caused by biophysical conditions, a case study of buhi Camarines sewer in the Philippines. So, just to give you an idea of what I'm going to talk about today, I'm going to give a brief introduction, including the objectives, the study site, and the limitations of this study, the results and analysis, particularly looking at the issues related to buhi Camarines sewer, the economics, the population, and the need for a paradigm shift or a paradigm change, and then my conclusions and recommendations. So the objective for this is to show the limits of growth using biophysical economic indicators and to propose an alternative development framework for the sustainability of buhi Camarines sewer. For those of you not too familiar where the Philippines is here, Southeast Asia, and my study site is not working. But anyway, buhi Camarines sewer is a first-class municipality, which means to say that it earns approximately 55 million pesos, or around 1.25 million US dollars. It has 38 barangays, 10 of which are located within the watershed of Buhi, or Lake Buhi, which is one of the most important bodies of water in that municipality. It has a current population of around 73,000 and a land area of around 24,000, divided into the watershed, the built-up area, the farmland, and of course, the open water space. Buhi is very interesting in the sense that it has a lot of water bodies, the most important of which is Lake Buhi, which has a surface area of around 1,700 hectares. And it has 14 tributary rivers, but only one outflow, which is the Tabo River. The lake itself is used for irrigation, hydropower, fishing, transportation, and recreational purposes. Out of the 10 barangays that are located within its watershed, there are six that are most important. These are the six listed: San Buena, Santa Cruz, Ipil, Santa Elena, Tambo, and Salvacion. Santa Elena happened to be the city or the municipal center. So another thing that makes Buhi very interesting is that it is the home of Sinarapan. This is, or the scientific name, Mysticis lucenensis. Thank you.
Thank you.